Today we're going to be taking a look at the Knuckbox K10, a powerful mini PC from GM KTech. It has a 14-core i9 processor, a great set of I/O, and upgradable storage and RAM, all in a compact package. In the box, first up we've got the Knuckbox K10. And underneath it is a sleeve with a user manual. Beneath that are two accessory boxes. The first has an HDMI and power cable, and the second has a power brick and two Wi-Fi antennas. The Knuckbox K10 is quite large as far as mini PCs go. It measures 178x176x40mm thick, and it weighs a touch over 1kg. Taking a look at the I/O, on the front we've got an audio jack, two USB 3.2 Type-A ports, one Type-C port that supports DisplayPort, two USB 2.0 ports, the power button, and a power indicator LED. The top has ventilation holes across the rear, and the two sides are solid. Around the back, we've got another two USB 3.2 ports and two USB 2 Type-A ports, two HDMI 2.0 ports, a full-size DisplayPort 1.4, 2.5GB Ethernet, an RS-235 serial port, DC power input, and two Wi-Fi antenna jacks. So you've got a wide range of ports available. I would have preferred to have seen a few more USB Type-C ports and perhaps a USB 4 port, but you've still got a lot of options. On the bottom is a really cool toolless access door that allows you to get to the two RAM slots and three M.2 ports for 2280 size NVMe drives. This is a really nice feature that makes upgrading the K10 really easy. This model comes with 32GB of RAM pre-installed and is expandable up to 96GB. RAM is dual channel, consisting of two 16GB DDR5 sticks running at 5200MHz. The supplied ADATA RAM is able to run at 5600MHz, but this CPU only supports up to 5200, so it'll run at that speed. We've also got one of the three M.2 ports populated with a 1TB Crucial P3 Plus drive. It's unusual to get three M.2 ports on a mini PC, so that's another nice feature. It's worth mentioning here though, that two of these slots are PCIe Gen 4x4 and one is Gen 3x3. In addition to being upgradable, it's also good to see that they've used decent quality components, and not a generic unbranded drive and RAM. The drive doesn't have a thermal pad, which would have been a nice feature since the metal access door is right above it. The top cover is also really easy to remove, with a single thumb screw securing it. Once loosened, the cover just slides off. Under the main cover, and with the fan and heatsink removed, we've got an Intel Core i9-13900HK. This is a powerful 13th gen Raptor Lake mobile CPU from 2023. It has 14 cores and 20 threads running at up to 5.4 GHz. The integrated Intel Iris graphics are likely going to hold the system back a bit, depending on your use case. The iGPU has 96 execution units running at up to 1.5 GHz. It's quite a power-hungry CPU with a TDP of 45 watts, so hopefully the cooler is able to deal with this. The cooler is a full copper heat pipe design, but since it's a mini PC, it is quite compact. It does however have quite a large fan, which should support better cooling and keep noise down. We've also got Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.2. On the hardware side, in terms of ease of use, this is definitely one of the easiest mini PCs I've ever opened up, with toolless access to the RAM and drive compartment and also to remove the main cover. Next, let's get it plugged in and booted up to run some tests on it. The power adapter provides 19 volts at up to 6.32 amps, for a total power of 120 watts, which is quite a lot for a mini PC. The Knuckbox K10 comes with Windows 11 pre-installed. The installation looks clean with no bloatware. If we open up Task Manager, we've got our Intel i9-13900HK CPU, with all 20 threads and a base speed of 2.6 GHz. We've also got 32GB of RAM running at 5200MHz, our 1TB NVMe SSD, an integrated Intel Iris graphics with 16GB of shared GPU memory. Now let's try run some benchmarks on it. Running the Geekbench CPU benchmark, we get a single core score of 2411 and a multi-core score of 12596. The averages over three tests were 2514 and 12606 respectively. These scores are pretty good for a mini PC, and would beat some more modern Core Ultra 7 series PCs. Running 3DMark Nightraid, which is tailored towards integrated GPUs, we get a score of 21,902. This consists of a graphics score of 25,166, which is near the top end of what is achievable with this iGPU, and is far better than older UHD graphics. It's likely good enough for low to medium settings on less demanding games, but it won't be good for any modern games. And then we have a CPU score of 12,624, which is quite good. Running a storage speed test with a 1GB file, the NVMe drive performs as expected for a Crucial P3 Plus drive in a Gen 4x4 interface, since the P3 Plus is a budget tier drive without DRAM. We get sequential reads of around 5,190 MB per second, and reads of around 4,750. I then tried running Counter-Strike 2 on it to see how the GPU performed. As expected, it's not great for gaming. At 1080p with graphics on medium settings, we get about 75 FPS. This is usable, but I expected a bit more from it. The GPU is very much the bottleneck of this PC. With graphics set to very high, this goes down to 30 FPS. So as expected, this isn't the mini PC to get if you're wanting to do some gaming. Throughout benchmarking and gaming, I was pleasantly surprised by how quiet the fan was. With a low load on the CPU, the fan runs at around 30 decibels, which is barely audible. Even under full load, the fan is a bit louder, getting up to about 39 decibels, but it's still pretty quiet. The fan also does a good job at keeping the CPU cool. Even under full load, the CPU didn't go over 60 degrees. I then measured power consumption. With this power-hungry CPU and large fan, it's on the higher end for many PCs. It uses around 18 watts when idle on the desktop, and when maxed out on all CPU and GPU cores, it uses around 84 watts. So not bad if compared to a desktop PC, but it is quite a lot for a mini PC. But keep in mind that this is a pretty powerful system. In terms of pricing, on the GMK Tech website, the bare-bones PC with no RAM or SSD installed is $420. This goes up to 590 with 64 gigs of RAM and a 1TB SSD. You can also often find them on sale on Amazon, so have a look there first. Overall, the GMK Tech Knockbox K10 delivers impressive performance for a mini PC. It has a strong CPU, and the integrated Iris Xe GPU is okay for its class. It'll be great as a home media center or for streaming, and while gaming performance in Counter-Strike was a bit underwhelming, it's still playable on low settings. It's impressively quiet, especially considering its power consumption. Its power draws on the high side for a mini PC, but that's the trade-off of having a more powerful CPU in a compact form factor. Overall, I think it's good value if you're looking for a powerful, quiet, and compact system. It'll fit right in as part of your home lab. I've added mine to my 3D printed Labrax home lab. Let me know what you think of the Knockbox K10 in the comment section below, and if there's anything else you'd like to see me test on it. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.